So far we have seen the release of pricey next gen video cards from AMD and Nvidia, so guys like these ones, but we are still waiting for the budget offerings from Nvidia and from AMD. Now the word on the street is that this wait could be over soon. There are some fresh rumors about the impending launch of a brand new AMD Radeon RX 7600 mid-range GPU. Now, if these rumors are true, then I think AMD could give Nvidia a serious run for their money in the mid-range GPU market. This video is brought to you by scdkey.com, where you can purchase Windows 10 Pro OEM keys for only $15.77. Use the link in the video description below to purchase Windows 10 Pro or Windows 10 Home OEM keys. And don't forget to use my 25% coupon code TP25. To activate your Windows license, press and hold Windows key plus S and type activation settings in the search box. Next, click on change product key at the bottom of the page and paste your newly purchased Windows 10 Pro OEM key. Wait for a few minutes and boom, your Windows 10 Pro is now fully activated. And by the way, you can always upgrade to Windows 11 Pro for free. You can also get Microsoft Office 2019 and various other PC games. So check the links that I've put in the video description below. And now let's get back to the video. So currently, AMD's top of the line graphics card is the Radeon RX 7900 XTX. And it is definitely a powerhouse with lot of impressive features. But at $1,000, this card is quite pricey. On the other hand, Nvidia's cheapest Ada Lovelace card is the RTX 4070 Ti, and that card is really not cheap. It sells for around $850, putting it out of the reach of most gamers. As a result, there are plenty of gamers in the mid-range GPU market who are still waiting to upgrade their GPUs. So for these gamers, finally, there is some exciting news. Apparently, a new GPU motherboard registration was recently filed in South Korea, and it indicates that a new AMD graphics card is on the horizon. According to a hardware leaker on Twitter, a new GPU using AMD's D707 board is ready for certification. Now, the current RX 7900 XTX graphics card is using D702 board, while the RX 7900 XT is using D704 board. So it's possible that the new D707 board could be paired with the Navi 33 GPU and used in both XT and non-XT variants of RX 7700 and RX 7600. Now, according to the Steam hardware survey, most PC gamers have not upgraded their GPUs. In fact, more than 40% of them are still using desktop graphic cards that are at least two generations old. So it's safe to say that a lot of these gamers would be eager to upgrade to a new GPU if the price was reasonable and a next-gen card was available to them. We all have seen how the bots were snatching up the limited GPU stock as soon as they were being made available in the last 2 years. At least the situation is very different now, and most of that madness has ended. In fact, now you can find these current gen Nvidia and AMD CPUs without much trouble. Amazon, Newegg, BNH Photo, as well as retail stores like Best Buy and Micro Center, they have plenty of GPUs in stock as of today. So while the shortage has ended, the prices are still not going down. Our only hope is that no one buys these ridiculously priced GPUs and AMD and Nvidia get to their senses and they stop selling their GPUs at such a high price and they do some price drop. Now, typically when a new generation of GPU hits the market, things follow a very predictable pattern. The high-end cards get all the attention at first, followed by the mid-range and followed by the budget options. But unfortunately, the pandemic and the crypto mania from the last 2 years, it really screwed up things, and Nvidia and AMD got used to insane GPU prices. As a result, both Nvidia and AMD are resisting the release of their mid-range and budget GPUs. In fact, Nvidia has been shamelessly trying to sell their last-gen cards, and they even tried to sell the GIMP 8GB version of RTX 3060. So this particular card, this is the RTX 3060 Ti, and AMD for the longest time was selling this card for way above the retail price. The scalpers were at one point selling this card for over $1,000. I mean, the madness was crazy. Now you can get this card for, this is the Founders Edition card. So if you're lucky, you can find this card for $399. But what I have seen is that most of the Founders Edition card are still sold out, or it's possible that Nvidia has stopped making them. But you can find RTX 3060 Ti cards, the board partner cards, and they are still going around for like $450 to $550. So the prices are still not coming down. So this makes me think that Nvidia will hold out on releasing the cheaper RTX 4060 when they announce the upcoming RTX 4070. And I think this gives AMD a real opportunity to drop a more affordable mid-range GPU. And let's be real, most gamers are still not playing at 4K. So a cheaper card that can perform well in 1080p and 1440p will be a huge draw. So I think if AMD does offer a more budget-friendly GPU right now, it could catch Nvidia off guard. After all, Nvidia is expected to stick to its usual pattern of releasing RTX 4070, followed by RTX 4060 Ti, followed by RTX 4060 and 4050. So if AMD drops RX 7600 now, and if most of the gamers jump on that card, then they will be less likely to switch to an RTX 4060 card when it finally drops. So even if RTX 4060 ends up being the best affordable graphics card of its generation, the performance difference may not be significant enough to justify paying more for Nvidia GPU. And this could really eat into Nvidia's market share in the mid-range segment. I would love to see Jensen Huang eat some shit and take a beating in the GPU market share. His arrogance and hubris really annoys me. But what I would really like to see is more affordable graphics card in the market right now. It's not realistic to expect everyone to have $700 to spend on new GPU, especially with the way economy is right now. It's about time that we everyday PC gamers catch a break. Nvidia has been pissing on us for the last 2 years. So I think AMD has a real opportunity here if they were to surprise us with the launch of an RX 7600 at a more reasonable price. It could very well be the game-changing mid-tier card that we all have been waiting for and could even convert some hardcore Nvidia fanboys. And let's be honest, who does not love a good underdog story? Another underdog is Intel, but I don't think Intel cards are ready for this generation. Maybe upcoming generations, their cards get better. But right now, it's just AMD and Nvidia. Lastly, for those who have deep pockets, or if you are willing to sell your kidneys, then the best GPU in the market right now is RTX 4090. Since its release, this GPU has been in very high demand and has been sold at exorbitant prices by scalpers on eBay. But finally, things seem to be changing, and recently I've noticed its availability both online and in stores, including my local Best Buy, where it's selling for $1650. For this price, you are getting a powerhouse GPU that will dominate all other graphic cards in 4K gaming. In the meantime, if you are looking for a graphics card, check out this video over here. In this video, I cover the best GPUs that you can buy right now in three price segments: $300, $450, and $1,000. So go ahead and watch that video, and I will see you guys over there. Bye.